Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is Hani Ismail from Planning Engineer website. In this interesting lesson, we are going to learn how to find the delayed activities and how to create a look-ahead schedule in Primavera P6. Delayed activities. As you proceed in your project, things might not follow the plan completely. So the baseline is not made 100% to be followed, or we are not expected that 100% of the activity will be exactly followed. There are a lot of changes, assumptions that we have made. That's why some deviation to the project might happen. So this is our original plan, and this is the actual progress. This situation is rarely happen on the site, that you start exactly the same date as planned and finish the same date as planned. And what happened? That the actual could be deviated from the planned. That's why it is important to find the delayed activities, and we'll learn how to do it in a second. So if you are not a planning engineer, or you are a stakeholder who is not familiar with Primavera P6, you might be in a situation where you need to know what are the delayed activities in your schedule. Let's agree that the schedule belongs to everyone is working on the project. Even if you are not a planning engineer, I would like to teach you how to find delayed activity by yourself. So knowing the delayed activity gives you indication of where you should take corrective actions. We can call an activity delayed activity when its actual progress is less than its planned progress. Actual progress in P6 is known as performance percentage completed, while planned progress is known as schedule percentage completed. Performance percentage completed is the actual percentage that you collect from the site and update your schedule in weekly or monthly basis. Schedule percentage completed is calculated by P6 from the baseline that you assign to your schedule. For example, this is a project where we have some activities. We can see here this is the schedule percentage completed, or the planned percentage, and here we have the performance percentage completed, or the actual percentages. In this screenshot, we have three cases: completed activities, in progress activities, not started activities. Usually, we don't give much attention to the completed activities, since it is already completed. For example, this RC column, it is already completed. We cannot do anything. But we pay attention to the in progress and not started. However, the not started, we can proactively make some action to make it starting on time. For example, this activity is forecasting to start after the planned date because it is linked to the masonry. So we can do something here to let this activity be completed on time, and accordingly this activity will start on time. So in progress activity is important to check and try to make it completed on time, because if it is completed on time, all the successor activities will be completed and started on time. For the masonry, the planned percentage is 50%, while the actual is 25%. So this is obviously a delayed activity. Insulation of roof system is also delayed. Why? Because the planned is more than the actual. Although it is forecasting, maybe it is a little bit delayed, but the concept is here. Is the planned is more than the actual, it means it is delayed. So in order to filter the delayed activities, we need to update our schedule with actual, then we can do the steps. So here, we have updated schedule, then we assign baseline to this updated schedule, then we show the columns of delays, which we are going to copy later on Excel, and then we can copy to Excel and do some filters on Excel. Very simple, don't worry. Even if you don't know anything in Primavera, you still can do this step. You will find link below this video to download the practice files so you can import them to your Primavera P6 and doing these steps. If you don't remember how to import the schedules to Primavera, please check the import and export video. So after we open or import our schedules, then we should show the schedule percentage complete, activity percentage complete columns. I will do it in front of you in a second. Then you just make right click and copy, okay? Then you go to any empty Excel sheet and paste them. Make Control T to convert the data into a table, then you can add a new column to calculate the variance, which is the planned minus the actual. So you will have here a variance column, and you will have this Excel sheet where you can apply filter on the variance to see the negative values, or you can see or make it number filtering and make less than zero, so it will give you the delayed activities. Let's go and see how to do it in practically in Primavera. So here, this is our schedule, and this one we imported last time. We created all these columns. Okay, and now I'm going to remove some columns I don't want and keep only the relevant columns. So I'll keep activity ID, I'll keep activity name, duration, then no need for planned start or planned finish or start or finish. I'll keep schedule percentage completed, performance percentage completed, and I'll remove everything else. You can keep them if you like. Now I have this small schedule. I'll be sure that no filters. I'll choose all activities to be sure that no filters are applied. Then I'll click here and I'll make Control A. So I select everything here, then make right click, copy. I'm going to open now empty Excel sheet. So this is my Excel sheet. Right click, paste. Now I have here my data from P6. I will select all my data here like this. Then I will make Control T on the keyboard to convert it to a table. I'll be sure to check that my table has headers. Now I can add one more column. I'll call it variance. So I'll make the formula to equal to actual minus the planned. Then I will make my filter is less than zero. So I will filter only the delayed activity. So here I have the delayed activity. If I would like to get rid of the WBS, I can also make one filter here to remove the blanks. These activities are delayed. So this is how simple it is. Very simple steps. You can have a list of your delayed activity. Second part of this video, we are going to talk about the look-ahead schedule. What is look-ahead? In order to be a proactive in your project, you need to look at what is going to happen. And as a proactive engineer, you should learn how to generate look-ahead schedule. Look-ahead schedule is something like a screenshot you can take from the future activities. You can assign how many weeks or days you would like to see the activities is in progress and going to start, or maybe going to be finished. So doing a look-ahead schedule is very simple. Let's do the steps for 1 week look-ahead schedule. We will show all the activities in progress, activities that will start during that week. So from filters, mainly we are doing look-ahead schedule using filters. There is one ready filter you can find, or you can create your own filter. In order to filter those activities on P6, we will use the filter and create one condition where the start is within range of current date plus 1 week. CD mean current date. Make sure to use option any of the following, because we are going to add another condition, because we have two conditions here: activity equals to in progress or start is within range of current date plus 1 week. And this is how it should looks like. Let's go and see how to do it in Primavera. So this is our schedule. So let's do our filter. I'll make a new filter. I'll call it look ahead. So later on I can use it, look ahead. I will choose the activity status, which will tell me the status of the activity is in progress. So I need to see all the in progress activities. I will add one more condition where the start date, I'll click S letter or ST to find the start. Now I will choose in within range of. Here, if you can see, you don't have to write anything. Just click here and click current date. Start typing more here. Make plus 1W. Plus 1W means plus 1 week. And I'll be sure that this one is any of the following, not all of the following. Because any condition will be met from these two, the activity should be shown. And then I can click apply, and here is my 1 week look ahead schedule. See, it is very simple, no complication at all. I think you should know how to do it if you are involved in any construction project. Once you have the schedule, you can do these steps by yourself. I hope you will find this video useful to you. See you in the next one.